Hello friends, in this video tutorial, we have start making user side module, and here we will create new user registration form with file upload, and send email verification link to new user under this library management system, by using PHP script. In previous part, we have already seen, how to delete or remove library book data under this library management system, so if you have not seen that part, so first view that part. Now let's start discussing this topic. So this MySQL database, and under this, we have user table, with fields like, user id, username, user address, user contact number, user profile, user email address, user password, user verification code, user verification status, user unique id, user status, user created on and user updated on. So when user registered under this library management system, so their registration data will be stored under this table. In second part, at the time of design template of this item, in index.php file, we have already create new user registration link, which we can seen here on web page, so by click on this link, user will redirect to user registration.php file. So here we have to open user registration.php file, and here first we want to include database connection.php file for making database connection. So here we have to write php include statement with database connection.php file. After this, we want to include function.php file. So here we have to write php include statement with function.php file name. Next we want to include header.php file, so here we have to write php include statement, and then after, we have to write header.php file name. And same way, we want to include footer.php file, so for this, here we have to write php include statement with footer.php file. So after including required file, now here we have paste this HTML code, so it will make blank template for new registration web page. Now here we have refresh web page, and after refresh of web page, here we can new user registration blank template has been created, which we can seen on web page. Now under this file, we want to create new user registration form. So for this, here first we want to create HTML form, so here we have to write form tag, with method is equal to post, and encryption type is equal to multipart form data, this is for upload file. Under this form, for enter user email address details, here we have to create text box. So for this, here we have to write, input type is equal to text, name is equal to user email address, and id is equal to user email address. After this, for enter user password details, here we have to create one password field. So for this, here we have to write, input type is equal to password, name is equal to user password, and id is equal to user password. Below this, we have to create input field, for enter user contact number detail. So here we have write, input type is equal to text, name is equal to user contact number, and id is equal to user contact number. Same way for enter user address details, here we have to create on text area field. So for this, here we have to write text area field tag, with name is equal to user address. And lastly, for upload user profile image, so for this, here we have to write, input type is equal to file, name is equal to user profile, and id is equal to user profile. Now for submit user registration form data, here we have to create one submit button. So for this, here we have to write, input type is equal to submit, name is equal to registration button, and value is equal to register. So by click on this button, user registration form data will be submitted. So here we have refresh web page, and after refresh of web page, here we can see that user registration form has been created. Now we have proceed for write PHP script for process user registration data. So here we have create two variable like $message variable is equal to blank value and $success variable is equal to blank value. Here in $message variable, we will store validation error, and under $success variable, we will store success message. Below this, we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write PHP is set function, and under this function, we have to write $postRegisterButton. If this variable value is set, that means user has clicked on submit button, then this block of code will execute. Under this block, we have to create $formData variable is equal to array. Under this variable, we will store form data. Now first we want to validate user email address data. So here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we call phpempty function, and under this function, we have to write $postUserEmailAddress variable. If this variable has blank value, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have append error message like email address is required. But suppose above condition false, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, first we want to check email address format. So here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write not operator with filter var function, with two argument. In first argument, we have to write $postUserEmailAddress variable, and in second argument, we have to write filter validate email. So this condition will check if email has come under invalid format, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to append error message like invalid email address. But suppose above condition false, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write $formData user email address variable is equal to $postUserEmailAddress variable. Next we want to validate user password field data. So for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write phpempty function, and under this function, we have to write $postUserPassword variable. Suppose this user password input field has blank value, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to append error message like password is required. But suppose above condition false, and user password has some value, then it will execute else block of code, and here we have to write $formData user password variable is equal to $postUserPassword variable. Next we want to validate username field data. So for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write phpempty function, and under this function, we have to write $postUserName variable. Suppose this username input field has blank value, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to append error message like username is required. But suppose above condition false, and username input field has some value, then it will execute else block of code, and here we have to write $formData username variable is equal to $postUserName variable. Next we want to validate user address field data. So for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write phpempty function, and under this function, we have to write $postUserAddress variable. Suppose this user address input field has blank value, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to append error message like user address is required. But suppose above condition false, that means user address input field has some value, then it will execute else block of code, and here we have to write $formData user address variable is equal to $postUserAddress variable. Next we want to validate user contact number input field data. So for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write phpempty function, and under this function, we have to write $postUserContactNumber variable. Suppose this user contact number input field has blank value, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to append error message like user contact number detail is required. But suppose above condition false, that means user contact number input field has some value, then it will execute else block of code, and here we have to write $formData user contact number variable is equal to $postUserContactNumber variable. Now we want to validate user profile image. So for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write not operator with PHP empty function, and under this function, we have to write $files user profile variable with name index. Suppose this condition false, that means user has not select profile image, and it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have append error message like, please select profile image. But suppose user has select profile image, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, first we have to write $image name variable is equal to $files user profile variable with name index. Below this, we have to write $image type variable is equal to $files user profile variable with type index. So here we have store image type property under this local $image type variable. Next we want to store image temporary location data in local variable. So here we have to write $temporary name variable is equal to $files user profile variable with temporary name index. After this, we want to get selected image width and height details, so for this, here we have to write $fileInfo variable is equal to @getImageSize function, and under this function, we have to write $temporary name variable. This function will return selected image size data. Now for get select image width data, here we have to define $width variable is equal to $fileInf variable with 0 index, so here we have store selected image width under this $width variable. Same way for store selected head data under local variable. So for this, here we have to create $height variable is equal to $fileInfo variable with 1 as index. So here we have to store selected image height property under this $height variable. Next we want to get selected image size. So for this, here we have to write $image size variable is equal to $files user profile variable with size index. So here we have store selected image size data under this $image size local variable. After this, we want to get selected image file extension. So here we have to write $image explode variable is equal to explode function with 2 argument. So under first argument, we have to write dot, and in second argument, we have to write $image name variable. So this function will convert image name into array. Now for get image extension from this array, we have to write $image extension variable is equal to PHP end function, and under this function, we have to write $image explode variable, so it will store image extension under this $image extension variable. Below this, we have to write $extensions variable is equal to different type of image extension in array format. Now first we want to check image extension variable, so here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write PHP in array function with 2 argument, in first argument, we have to write $image extension variable, and $extensions variable. So suppose selected image file extension, now found under this $extensions variable array, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to append error like invalid image file. But suppose user has select proper extension image file, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, now we want to check image size validation like image file size must not large than 2 megabyte. So for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write $image size variable value is less than 2 megabyte. So this condition will check if selected file is greater than 2 megabyte, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to WR type $message variable, and under this variable, we have to append error message like image size exceed 2 megabyte. But suppose user has select image less than 2 megabyte, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, now we want to validate image width and height detail, so for this, here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write $width variable value is equal to 225, and $height variable value is equal to $225. So this condition will check, if selected image width and height is not equal to 225 pixel, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write $message variable, and here we have to append error like image dimension should be within 225 into 225. But suppose image dimension must be proper, then it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $new image name variable is equal to php time function with php random function, and after this, we have to append value of $image extension variable, so it will create new image name. Now for upload user profile image, here we have to write, if statement and under condition, we have to write php move uploaded file function, with two argument, in first argument, we have to write $temporary name variable, and in second argument, we have to write $upload folder name slash $new image name variable. So it will upload user profile image under upload folder, and after this, it will execute if block of code, and under this block, we have to write $form data user profile variable is equal to $new image name variable. So here we have store all form data under this $form data variable in array format. After validate all form data, now here we have to write, if statement and under condition, we have to write, $message variable is equal to blank, if this condition true, that means there is no any validation error has occurred, and it will execute if block of code. And under this block, first we want to check, user email address is already registered or not, so for this, here we have to write, $data variable is equal to array. And in array key, we have to write :// user email address, and in value, we have to write $form data user email address variable. After this, we have to write $query variable is equal to select star from user table, and under where condition, we have to write user email address is equal to :// user email address. Now below this query, we have to write $statement variable is equal to $connect variable with prepare method, and under this method, we have to write $query variable, so it will make query for execution. Next for execute above query, we have to write $statement variable with execute method, and under this, we have to write $data variable, so this method will execute above query. After this, we have to write, if statement and under condition, we have to write, $statement variable, with row count method, greater than 0, so here this row count method, will return number of row affected after query execution, and if that number is greater than 0, then it will execute if block of code. And under this block, we have to write, $message variable is equal to, error message like email already register. But suppose above condition false, then it will execute else block of code, and under this block, we have to write $user unique id variable is equal to capital U alphabet, and after this, we have to append number, which will be generate using php random function, so it will generate user unique number. And below this, we have to create $data variable is equal to array. In array first key, we have to write :// username, and in value, we have to write $form data username variable. In array second key, we have to write :// user address, and under value, we have to write $form data user address variable. Under array third key, we have to write :// user contact number, and under value, we have to write $form data user contact number variable. In array fourth key, we have to write :// user profile, and under value, we have to write $form data user profile variable. Under array fifth key, we have to write :// user email address, and in value, we have to write $form data user email address variable. In array sixth key, we have to write :// user password, and under value, we have to write $form data user password variable. Under array seventh key, we have to write :// user verification status, and in value, we have to write no. In array 8th key, we have to write double colon user unique id, and under value, we have to write dollar user unique id variable. Under array 9th key, we have to write double colon user status, and in value, we have to write enable. In array last key, we have to write double colon user created on, and in value, we have to write get date time function, with dollar connect variable as argument, so this function will return current date and time data, so here we have store all data, under this dollar data variable in array format. Now below this, we have to write $query variable is equal to insert into user table, with table column like username, user address, user contact number, user profile, user email address, user password, user verification status, user unique id, user status and user created on. With values get from double colon username, user address, user contact number, user profile, user email address, user password, user verification status, user unique id, user status and user created on. So here our insert data query is ready. And below this, we have to write $statement variable is equal to $connect variable with prepare statement, and under this, we have to write $query variable, so it will make query for execution. Now we want to execute above query, so here we have to write $statement variable with execute method, and under this, we have to write $data variable. So this method will execute above insert query, and it will insert user data, under user table. And after this, we have to write $success variable is equal to, your registration is completed, and your verification status is pending. Now we want to display validation error on web page, so here we have to write if statement, and under condition, we have to write $message variable value is not equal to blank, if this condition true, then it will execute if block of code. And under this block, we have to write PHP echo statement, with division tag, with class is equal to alert and alert danger bootstrap library class, and between this tag, we have to write $message variable, so it will display validation error on web page. Same way, we want to display success message on web page, so here we have to write, if statement and under condition, we have write, $success variable value is not equal to blank. If this condition true, then it will execute if block of code. And under this block, we have to write PHP echo statement, with division tag with class is equal to bootstrap library alert and alert success class, and between this, we have to write $success variable, so it will display success message on web page, so here our code is ready, now we have check output in browser. So friends, first we have refreshed this web page, and after refresh of web page, here we can see that user registration form has been displayed on web page. First we want to check validation is working or not, so here we have directly click on submit button, and after click on submit button, here we can see that validation error has been displayed on web page. Now we want to check this form is accept invalid email address, so here we have enter invalid email address, and after this, we have to click on register button, and after click on register button, here we can see that it has not accept invalid email address. Next we want to check it has accept other file format file or not, so here we have select file, and click on register button, and after click on register button, here we can see that invalid file format error message has been displayed. Now we want to check image dimension validation, so here we have select image whose height and width is not equal to 225 pixel. And then after we have click on register button, and after this, here we can see validation error like image height and width must be 225 pixel. So here all validation working properly. So now we have fill form detail like user email address, user password, username, user contact number, user address and lastly, we have to select user profile image one by one. after fill user registration form data, with select user profile image, now we have to click on register button, and after click on register button, here we can see success message like, user registration complete, but your verification status is pending on web page. So here our user registration form is ready, without user email address verification. So in this part, we have make user registration form, and then after, we have write PHP script for validate form data, and upload user profile image on server, and lastly, we have to insert user registration data under user table. In next part, we will generate user email verification email, and send that verification email to user email address by using PHP mailer library, and then after, we will learn how to validate user email addresses real or fake, by validate user email address by using PHP script. So we will be meet in next part, and lastly thank you for watching this video.